G'day. You're watching this video and your first question might be, why is there a car parking app on an educational app video channel? Well, my goal is to actually make some educational apps of my own, but first I need to make some money. So to do that, I've actually made a simple car parking app that was probably a bit more economically viable to make. It's ad supported, so it's free for you, the user, and hopefully it can generate some ad income for me, which I can then put towards making some great educational apps. So I'm asking for your help in this video. If you take a look at it and you like what you see with this app, please download and use the app, and hopefully I'll get out some excellent educational apps that you will be able to use in your classroom with your students. Thanks. So this is my car parking app. The first thing to notice is it's ad supported, which means it's free for you, the user. If you didn't want the ads, you can do an in-app purchase to remove those, or there is a pro version of the app, but this one has all exactly the same features. Okay, so you've got two choices. You've got car park or street park. Now, a car park is basically for when you're in a multi-story car park, like at a shopping center. You have all these different settings that can help remind you where you've parked your car. So you can choose a level, so I might be on level 11. You can set the floor if there's a letter for your floors. You can also have sections, so sometimes there's lower, upper, ground, basement. You can put in a car space number if they give space numbers. You can also choose a color, because often the floors have particular colors. So select your color, click done. You can also add colors to a favorites list. So I've got a list of my favorite colors for places I park regularly, but I'm gonna choose the red. Then what you do, the app will automatically put in the time for you, the current time based on the time on your iPhone. If you can actually change that if you need to, so you can change the date and the time, etc. If you've missed it, put in your time limit. So my limit for parking is 1 hour and 15, and then it automatically calculates your expiry time. Now what you do next is you tap on this first button up here, which allows you to set a time at which the alarm will go off. So I can have the alarm go off at the time of expiry, 5, 15, 30 minutes before, 1 or 2 hours. So you won't get caught out overrunning your time and having to pay a fine. So I'll do at the time expires. Once you've set an alarm time, that icon goes yellow. The other options we have is you can add in some of your own notes. So if you click that, you just need to click save note. That's saved for you, so that's as a reference. And you can clear all the data if you wanted to just reset everything at once. So you can hit clear all. So that's the car park view, as I said, for multi-story car parks. If we flick over to the street view, so this is when you've parked on the street. It doesn't help you find a spot, but once you find a spot, you can set where you've parked and it'll help you find your way back to your car. So once again, the arrival time auto inputs. We'll get a 2 hour time limit for this one. It gives me the finish time. I can set an alarm, so I'll do 5 minutes before. And here, if you press this, it'll actually set your map location. So it drops a pin where you're located. You can now leave that and it will track where you are, and we'll go back to that later and see how we use that to get back to our car. We have an option to add photos, so this is on both settings. You can add an image, so you can either take a photo with your camera or you can choose one from the image gallery, and then once that's done, you can then view the photo that you've saved here. So you can take a photo of the location where your car's parked or some significant landmark and have a copy of that on that tab there. If you wanted to replace that, you can see you've got a camera roll option, so you could go across to your camera roll, or you can just go back to your camera icon and take a different photo to replace that. When you're ready to return to your car, head back to the map screen. It shows you where you originally parked, where it dropped a pin, and it shows you where you currently are. If you hit the Show Path tab, it will show you the way to get back to your car. So you can then walk along and track your way back to your car. Another good feature with the map, you can hit Clear All, so it'll reset your map. And say you forget to set the map immediately when you park your car, and maybe you're a street or two away, you can actually grab the pin and drop it back at the original spot where you parked, if you can remember that. And then you can keep walking and eventually find your way back to your car. So that's the app overall. When the alarm's set, you get notifications come up just as they normally would for any other app that has notifications, and an alarm will sound as well, as long as the sound's on your phone, and it'll vibrate. So a simple way to help you remember where you've parked your car in a multi-story car park or on the street and find your way back to your car.